सहनावतु सहनौभुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावतीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। सल्यूटेशन्स टू मास्टर ओंबुल स्वामी सद्गुरु शिवानंद महाराज की जय। ओंबुल स्वामी विष्णु देवानंद महाराज की जय। हरि ओम तत्सत ओम नमः शिवाय। विद द ग्रेस ऑफ मास्टर्स विल स्टार्ट आवर भगवद्गीता क्लास ऑनलाइन फ्रॉम टुडे ऑनवर्ड्स। विल डिस्कस द चैप्टर 1 विद द 5 श्लोकस टुडे। जस्ट बिफोर द गीता स्टार्ट्स, the born blind old man, the king Dhritarashtra, who is not only physically blind, he is blind in his own attachment to his children, however vicious they may be. The old man sitting in a quiet place in his kingdom, he had the consciousness in him that his sons are walking in the wrong path, in the criminal path. The sense of guilty prevails in him. He cannot accept. Why he cannot accept? Because they are my children. Whenever there is an attachment that comes, then the injustice supersedes it. He knows very well that what his son Duryodhana is doing is injustice. Refusing a piece of land to the deserved people, what he is doing is wrong. Because of the attachment, he has become blind. Whenever there is an attachment, you become blind intellectually. The discriminatory power in you goes away. The judging power goes away. We take the sides. So he was sitting in this kingdom with all this guilt feeling in him. Vyasa Maharishi, who walks in to the palace, he is the author of Mahabharata. He see the blind man, the king Dhritarashtra. So he suggests to the king, you cannot see the civil war that's taking place. Therefore, with my tapas, I can give you temporary power to see the entire, to watch the entire war that is going on. King Dhritarashtra thought for a moment and he said, thank you, I don't want to see. Such a big offer. He is blind. Temporarily he is giving the power to vision to watch everything. But the king says, no, I don't want to see. Why he says that? Because he knew in the long run, the vicious and the wicked will definitely come to suffer. And maybe his own children will die in the war. And he doesn't want to see that. He has no guts to see the consequences of his son's own actions. Vyasa Maharishi, okay, fair enough. Would you like to have a running commentary so that you can hear what is going on live in the civil war? You can nominate somebody. The king Dhritarashtra again take a moment to think and he says, that I would love to. I would love to hear that. That's a very good option. Now I can recommend, I can suggest my secretary, the secretary of the kingdom, Sanjaya. you can give the power to him. He can sit in this palace next to me and explain everything. Okay, Vyasa Maharishi says, Tathastu, I'm giving you that power. Now Sanjaya will get the power to see the entire world war and give a running commentary to the king. It's like a TV television screen, but it is not like a TV. How is it different? Television will only display the forms. Here, Vyasa Maharishi is giving the power to Sanjaya to see the minds of each individuals in the war. He can not only see the form name, he can see what is going on in their mind, each individual's mind, what is going on, what are their sentiments, what is the emotion that's passing through the mind. Everything he can explain now. He has got that power. Vyasa Maharishi is giving that power. And Vyasa leaves, giving this power. Now Sanjaya, he has got a big responsibility because he will have to explain to a blind man. It's not that easy to explain to a blind man. Sanjaya have to be really exhaustive in giving the complete details. So exhaustively, Sanjaya expresses all the moments, all the emotions, all the sentiments of all the individuals in the civil war. Now, this is with this background, the Bhagavad Gita starts. In sloka number 1, Dhritarashtra, the king who is blind, he is asking Sanjaya to explain what's happening in the civil war. That is the first sloka. We'll chant the sloka number 1. Dhritarashtra vacha dharma kshetre kuru kshetre samaveta yuyutsavaha mamaka pandavas chaiva kima kurvata sanjaya. Dhritarashtra vacha. Vacha means he asks, he says, he utters these words. Dharma kshetre kuru kshetre. Kuru kshetre is that civil war, war room. Why is he calling it as Dharma Kshetre? Because it is the responsibility of a Kshatriya to fight. They are there to fight against their own Dharma. Each and everyone who is standing in that war room, they are standing there to fight for the Dharma. So it's called Dharma Kshetre. Dharma Kshetre, Kuru Kshetre, Samaveda Yuyutsavaha. Samaveda means assembled. Yuyutsavaha means desirous to fight. Every individual who is standing in that war room, they desire to fight. So Dhritarashtra is asking, Dharma Kshetre Kuru Kshetre, in the Kshetra, in that civil war, in the war room, the people who are desirous to fight, they are assembled. Mamakaf Pandavas Chaiva. Mamakaha means my people. See the attachment here? That's clearly explained. First he is putting my people. He is not putting the Pandava in the first place. He is only putting my people, showing clearly that he is blind towards his attachment. Mamakaf Pandavas Chaiva. What are my people and Pandavas? Kima kurvata Sanjaya. Kima means what? Kurvata, kuru to do. What are they doing? Sanjaya, oh Sanjaya, in Dharma Kshetre, Kuru Kshetre, in that civil war where the people are ready to, desirous to fight. Mamakav Pandavas Chaiva, my people and Pandava, what are they doing? Please explain. This is what is the first sloka. He's asking Sanjaya to give the explanation, to express what is happening there. Sloka number 2. Sanjay vacha drishtva tu pandava nikam vyudam duryodhanastata आचार्यमुपसंगम्य राजा वचनमब्रवीत. नाउ संजय इट इज हिज रेस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी टू एक्सप्रेस एवरीथिंग इन विथ डिटेल्स. दृष्ट्वा, दृष्ट्वा मीन्स हैविंग सीन. दृष्ट्वा तु पांडवा नीकम. पांडवास आर स्टैंडिंग ऑन द ऑपोजिशन साइड. व्यूडम दुर्योधनस्तथा. दुर्योधना तथा नाउ दुर्योधना हैविंग सीन द व्यूडम. व्यूडम मीन्स हाउ इट इज अरेंज्ड, द वे इट इज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड. हैविंग सीन द पीपल पांडवा नीकम, हैविंग सीन द पीपल स्टैंडिंग इन द ऑपोजिशन, he walks near to the acharya. acharya upasangamya. acharya upasangamya. upa means near. upa means near. sangamya going near the acharya. acharya here refers dronacharya. dronacharya is a teacher for both the opposition party and the ruling party. who is the ruling party here? the duryodhana, kaurava side, and the opposition is pandava. for both of them Acharya was Dronacharya, who taught them the archery. Duryodhana, the Raja, the Prince, walked towards the Acharya and he starts speaking. Vachanam abravit. He starts using these words. Vachanam means words. So Duryodhana, the eldest brother of Gauravas, he is uncompromisingly vicious. Now he want to rule. He want the chair. He want to be rule the kingdom. He want the power. When you are obsessed completely, then you will somehow you have to get that. Duryodhana is obsessed to get the to rule the kingdom. So whenever this sort of desires that come into your mind, you will start thinking, and when he starts looking at himself, he knows there is a little element of fear in Duryodhana. Though he is obsessed, though he has a desires, he is not ready to compromise. He want to rule the kingdom, everything. He want to possess the power, wealth, everything. He won't share a piece of land to Pandavas. Everything is there, yet in the mind there is a element of fear. He knew what he is doing is wrong. He is tempted because there is a desire. Whenever there is a desire that arises in any one of us, for that matter, it is applicable to all of us in the day to day life. Whenever there is an element of desire that comes in our mind, we somehow we want to fulfill that desire immediately. Let me enjoy that. I want that. You know there is a trouble, that there is a consequence out of that desire, but the desire is so strong, you are ready to face the consequences. It's okay, the consequences I will face it later. Now I want to fulfill that desire. The same way Duryodhana, there are consequences. He said, I want to rule the kingdom. There is an element of fear in him. This is what is clearly explained in this sloka. That element of fear, it is bringing a little shaky in Duryodhana. So he walks near to the Acharya and he starts using these words. Sloka number 3. Pashyetam panduputranam आचार्य महतीं चमूं व्यूढां द्रुपदपुत्रेण तव शिष्येन धीमता. ही इज गोइंग टू द आचार्य एंड ही इज टेलिंग दुर्योधना द प्रिंस, ही इज टेलिंग पश्येतां पांडुपुत्राणां. पश्येतां मीन्स सी द पांडुपुत्रास. पांडुपुत्र, पांडु इज द फादर ऑफ पांडवास. Putra means son. See the Panduputra standing on the opposite. Mahatim Chamum. Mahatim means he magnifies. Mahatim means magnifies. he goes to the acharya. Acharya very well, Dronacharya can see everything. He is also standing next to him. He is the one who taught the archery for both the ruling party and the opposition party. He can very well see. This shows that Duryodhana is little restless. So he walks into the acharya and says, "Acharya, see Panduputranam, they are standing on the opposite." He magnifies and he says, "See the Vyudam. Vyudam means how they are organized, how they are how they have organized the army array, how they have formed the Vyudam. Vyudam Drupadaputrena." Drupadaputran here refers to Arjuna. "See, they are standing there, and your Sishya Drupadaputra, he is bringing the subtle way of putting his restlessness. See, your Sishya, to whom you taught all these expertise of forming the Vyudam, he is organized. You don't know whom to teach, whom not to teach. You taught everything. Now he is standing against us using what you have taught." All these usage of words clearly explain the mental conditions of our hero Duryodhana. Whenever the desire comes strongly in you, you lose the discriminatory power, and the indiscriminatory power creeps in you. And when the anger that comes in your usage of words, either it is going to hurt your guru or your parents or your sisters, you don't bother, because that desire, the attachment to that desire is so strong. Somehow I want to get this. His restlessness, that what he is doing is not correct, that is also, the fear is also creeping in him. And all these are showing that indiscriminatory words out of him. "See Guru, Acharya, look at your Sishya, what he is brought in front of us." Sloka number 4. "Atra Sura Maheshvasa Bhimarjuna Samayudhi Yuyudhano Viradascha Drupadascha Maharataha." He is telling in the 4th sloka, Atra, there, Sura, great courageous people. Maheshvasa means here mighty archers. How do what they say is, when some people get the power, mighty archers, great courageous people, they are all standing in opposite. Bhima and Arjuna, both of them are mighty archers. Yuyudhano Viratascha Drupatascha Maharataha. Tripata, Yuyudhana, Virata, Drupata, these are all the characters. Those who know the Mahabharata, they might know, when you utter the name of these characters, who are they and what is their character, what are their behavior. So when they utter these, when Sanjaya utter this name, the king Dhritarashtra understands who are they. Maharataha means, it is a title given to any individual who can single-handedly fight more than 500 people. When somebody has the potential, they are all given the title as Maharatha. Maharataha means people who can fight individually. Okay. See, now Duryodhana is telling, all these people are standing in the opposition side. In his side, there are the number of people, the number of commanders are huge. Many people are standing in his side. In the opposite side, there are few people who are there still. Duryodhana says, the Bhima and Arjuna, they are hard to win the battle. each of them, they have already proved they individually their winning potential. That is giving little restlessness to Duryodhana. That is what he is explaining in sloka number 4. Sloka number 5. Drishta ketuschekitanaha kasirajascha viryavan purujit kunti bojascha saibhyascha narapungavaha. Again, he is listing the men who is standing, who are famous. Duryodhana recognized them and he is naming the each and every person as though Drona cannot see. Drona can very well see. Acharya is also standing next to him. He knows everybody. He can see everybody. All the Viryavan. Viryavan means the most courageous people. The king of Kasi is a most courageous people. Narapungavaha means cultured people who are all standing there. Duryodhana is naming them again. Which Dronacharya can very well see. Still, Duryodhana is coming near and uttering all these words, naming all the great officers who are standing in the opposite side. What these all explains is Duryodhana demonstrates that he is little nervous. Whenever we are little nervous, why this comes in, that nervousness or that unsteady mind, the disturbed feeling, you don't know what we are doing. We can experience this in our day-to-day life also. The person who is sitting next to us, who can clearly see everything, but still we would be explaining everything to them. That time it is clearly, you can feel that you are restless. Whenever the attachment that comes, we get into the indiscriminatory mode. We lose the discriminatory power. We lose the judging power. The attachment towards our own son, the attachment towards our own family people, the attachment towards our own desires to possess the kingdom, to possess wealth, to possess more things. We know sometimes we are clearly wrong. What we are doing is wrong. This desire is wrong. The attachment to achieve the desire is wrong, but still we want to achieve. Those times we become blind. We are not ready to yield to any of those right feeling. We wanted to achieve this. Knowing very well there are consequences for our actions, we think that it is okay, we will do it now. There are consequences, I'm ready to face the consequences. That is blindfold. The attachment always brings this blindness in us. We lose that judgment capacity, right or wrong. Everything takes a back seat. We want to achieve. So these slokas, starting itself from Duryodhana, we can clearly understand that whenever sometimes these kind of attachment creeps in us, we can clearly apply this into our day-to-day life, into our own family. When our family people are doing a mistake, instead of blindly following that attachment and supporting them, we need to pick up the courage in us and tell them that what they are doing is wrong. That courage will come only when we are becoming little conscious. There is nothing wrong in getting desirous to achieve everything. All of us are in the day-to-day life. We have a desirous to achieve something. We have goals. We have everything. At the same time, we shouldn't be strongly attached to it. We need to know what is right, what is wrong. When it is wrong, at that time, we need to bring down this attachment towards it and give more power to the dharmic words. To our own people, we need to pick up that courage. We need to pick up that we need to put our injustice down. pick up that discriminatory power and tell what you are doing is wrong. This is dharma. This is what is to be done. This is what is right. If you are doing this wrong, you are bound to face the consequences. This applies to not only to our family people, we can apply this to our own self. When we get strongly attached to something and we also know there is a fear that is coming in, then that's the time we need to question ourselves and pick up courage to tell ourselves to detach from that desire, feeling, and do what is right, what is dharma. With these 5 slokas, we'll conclude. Tomorrow we'll pick up the next 5 slokas between 5 and 10, at the same time between 4 and 4:30. We'll end the class keeping our back straight, sitting comfortably, eyes gently closed. We'll chant Om 3 times together. Om. 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 Om Trayambakam Yajamahe Sugantim Pushtivardhanam Urvarukamiva Bandhanat Mrityon Mukshiyamamritat. ॐ त्रयम्बकं यजामहे सुगन्धिं पुष्टिवर्धनम् उर्वारुकमिव बन्धनात् मृत्योन्मुक्षीयमामृतात्. ॐ त्रयम्बकं यजामहे सुगन्धिं पुष्टिवर्धनम् उर्वारुकमिव बन्धनात् मृत्योन्मुक्षीयमामृतात्. ॐ सर्वेषां स्वस्तिर्भवतु, सर्वेषां शान्तिर्भवतु, सर्वेषां पूर्णं भवतु, सर्वेषां मङ्गलं भवतु, सर्वे भवन्तु सुखिनः, सर्वे सन्तु निरामया, सर्वे भद्राणि पश्यन्तु, मा कश्चित् दुःखभाग् भवेत्. असतो मा सद्गमय, तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमय, मृत्योर्मा अमृतं गमय. ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते, पूर्णस्य पूर्णमाधाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते. ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः. Salutations to Master Ombola Swami Sadguru Shivananda Maharaj ki jai. Ombola Swami Vishnu Devananda Maharaj ki jai. Thank you so much for joining and giving me this opportunity. Surrendering to Swami. See you tomorrow.